Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Kerry and today we are going to be doing a tag video. I've just been watching Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner do a tag video that she started, so I'm hopping on the bandwagon and I want to answer the questions that she made for this tag. So please stick around and don't forget to subscribe. If you do hear noises in the background, that is just my little kitten, Zuko, having the time of his life. He is my little filming buddy, especially if you hear little bells. It's not Christmassy things I've added to this. It's literally just my cat with his bell. So all of these questions are related to eyeshadow palettes, which is why I really wanted to do this tag, because eyeshadow palettes are my passion. I love reviewing them, using them, doing bright, colourful looks like the one I'm wearing now. I did use the new Nomad Santa's Village palette for this look, and I'm excited to dive into these questions. I've got some palettes in front of me. It was actually more difficult than I thought to think of the answers. I will link Annette's video to this tag down in the description box, so please check it out if you haven't already seen it. And the first question in this tag is most innovative release of the year. Okay, I knew the second I read this question what it was going to be, and it has to be, without a doubt, the Cosmic Brushes Serenity palette. I absolutely love this palette. This may be my favourite release of the year. I'm not sure. I am planning to do maybe a top 10 palettes of the year video, so do stick around if that's something you'd be interested in. I will have that coming, but Cosmic Brushes wasn't really on my radar, or a lot of people's radars. They had already released the Royal Rose palette, which was really, really nice and pretty. Wasn't aware of them. Then this cool story was popping up on Instagram and everyone was losing their minds, and rightly so, because it is absolutely stunning. I think it's a combination with this palette. It is the fact it is an indie brand, UK based, which a lot of my favourite indie brands are in the US, so I am so happy to have found one in the UK. There are a few in the UK that I like, but the more the merrier. The packaging of this is absolutely beautiful. It's nice and cardboard, nice rounded corners, and the colours on the front reflect the colour story on the inside, which I appreciate. I really like the layout of this palette, how it's been curated. The colours in this are just phenomenal. It is such a beautiful colour story. I've not seen one quite like this. It's so pleasing to look at. I can't tell you how much I love this palette. It is absolutely beautiful. And not just that, but the actual pigment of the shades, the blendability, the incredible intense shimmers. Everything about this palette is a 10 out of 10 for me. And that is probably why it has sold out so many times and had to be restocked. And it is so affordable. This retails for £20. For this quality, this colour story, I'm sorry, that is an absolute steal. So this had to be the first answer to that question. But also, innovative, my friend did remind me about the Ace Beauté Paletteopoly palette. How could I have forgotten about this? Innovative, yes. Okay, lots of people on YouTube do lots of videos to do with, what's the word? Palette bingo. There are so many palette bingos out there and I love watching them. I love creating them myself. I've done a few on my channel, but to actually do a real game with cards and a pad and a paper and all the different elements to this, I did pick up the PR box, but you can just buy the palette on its own with the game. And I just think, what an amazing concept. I think they really did something special with this, and not only the concept and the fact that it's such a different game style way to do your makeup and have fun, it is also the amazing quality that Ace Beauté have in their formula. I absolutely love this palette. The mattes are pigmented, blendable, beautiful putty-like shimmers, if that is something that you're interested in. And I really like that it's set out in different rows like this, so it's easy if you just want to do an easy monochromatic look. We have depth, we have light shades, and we have mid-tones. I'd say this is ridiculously innovative. Okay, and the second question is, palette that surprised you the most? Okay, I have two, and the first one is definitely the Nomad Cosmetics Hudson Valley palette. Nomad Cosmetics are a fantastic indie brand based in the US. I think they are amazing. I love the concepts of their palettes. They are destination based. So this one is obviously based in Hudson Valley. And I'm not normally the biggest lover of neutrals or neutral leaning type palettes. And this isn't your typical neutral palette, but it is more on the neutral side. So I feel like colour lovers will like it and neutral lovers will like it. But this surprised me because I knew I was going to like it because it's the Nomad quality. But it surprised me because I actually love this colour story. And seeing it online, I knew I wanted to buy it. But actually using it in person and playing with it, I enjoyed it as much as I would a rainbow palette. I love reaching for this palette, especially the reds. I think they're beautiful. The nice green tones in this. It is such a good palette, and it did kind of surprise me. Using it, I'm just like, I actually love this a lot more than I thought I was going to. Also, another big surprise for me, I didn't think this year I was going to be lusting after a fully neutral palette, but here I am. And I've got the Colourpop Not a Box of Chocolates palette. I have done a video on this, and I'm explaining in that, or not explaining, and just saying I don't really understand why I was lusting after this palette, because, like I say, I'm not the biggest neutral lover on the planet, but there's something about this palette. And it did surprise me that I was really, really drawn to it, and I'm not sure what it is. I still can't really put my finger on it, but the quality of this is amazing. The pigment of these browns, like, go in lightly because there is a lot of pigment. The shimmers are beautiful. The shades that I've used in this palette, I haven't used every single one yet, but beautiful quality. And yeah, it has really surprised me that me, Kerry, rainbow loving Kerry, wanted and loves this palette. Okay, the next one is a palette you regret buying. Now, I have just recently done a regrets video. But the palettes I regret buying, I do have three in this category, and one of them I did mention in that video. So I have the Colourblock Huda Beauty palette, and it is the orange and purple one. And when I saw these released, this one and the other one, I do own the other one as well. I don't really regret that as much because I prefer the colour story of the green and blue. But this one, I mean, I can understand it and I can see why I wanted it, but actually the quality of this is it's just not as good as a lot of palettes in my collection. I don't think it's as good quality as the bigger Huda palettes, such as Mercury Retrograde, for example. I don't like the fact it's got a split pan. That really annoys my OCD brain. Sorry, I'm back. I just had to answer the front door. The postman was knocking. But yeah, it does have an water-activated liner in this palette, which is this one here, and I can see what they're trying to do with these colour blocks because they wanted complementing colours that were sort of contrasting, but they don't really work together blending wise. So if you're trying to blend a purple in with an orange, it's going to turn into a muddy mess. So I feel like although that looks beautiful together, the purple and the orange, it's not actually the easiest to pair together. And like I say, the quality, definitely not the best. And I am so out of breath right now. Okay, another regret for me is the e.l.f. Cookies and Dreams palette. I did mention this in my regrets video. I mean, it's not the most expensive palette. It is very, very affordable. And I like the theming that e.l.f. did with the Cookies and Dreams. And I do like blues and browns together. I just think the quality isn't the absolute best and I really, really don't reach for it. So I kind of do regret buying this one. And although it's got mid-tones, deep tones, light shades, it's got shimmers, it had everything going for it in what I like in an eyeshadow palette, but I just don't reach for it and I don't think the formula is the best. Okay, my last regret is, unfortunately, because I really do love Unearthly Cosmetics as a brand in general, especially their eyeshadow palettes, but this palette just doesn't do it for me, and it's the leather and lace palette, and I really, really don't reach for this. And it is not because of the colour story. I really liked the look of the colour story of this palette. Unearthly Cosmetics are an indie brand in the US, and I have a lot of their palettes, and I really like a lot of them, but this one is just not it for me. There's just something about the quality of these shadows that is just not the same as my other palettes, especially the mattes. Like, I don't know what it is, but they feel different. I can't really put my finger on it. I do like the fact that they are laid out in rows, so it's really easy to do a nice cohesive look, but there's just, I don't know. It's just not the same formula that I'm used to from Unearthly, and I don't know if I'm the only one that feels like that, but I just end up not reaching for it because it's not my favourite formula, and it just makes me really sad. So I do kind of regret picking this one up. It's not the cheapest palette, and the shipping to me to the UK is very, very expensive. Also, I do feel like the packaging of this one sends my eyes a little bit funny, especially compared to the colour story that is in the palette, but I don't know. Let me know your thoughts on this. Have you picked this up? Is this the good Unearthly Cosmetics quality formula to you? Because for me, it feels very different. I do apologise if we have slightly moved in any way, shape or form, but my memory card was full and I needed to sort that out. And now I can have a coffee break. Okay, the next question is best collaboration. And for me, no brainer, two palettes pop to mind straight away. And the first one is the Odens Eye and Angelica Nyqvist Hela palette. You can't actually get this anymore. It has recently stopped being sold on the Odens Eye website, but it was around for quite a long time. Angelica Nyqvist is one of my favourite YouTubers to watch by far. I love her makeup style. I absolutely love Odens Eye, their formula, their packaging, and it is a stunning palette. This colour story is amazing. It's got greens and I absolutely love green eyeshadow. Angelica knows what she's talking about with colour stories, and when she's putting them together, she knows what she wants. And I feel like because we have very similar tastes in makeup, she knows that people are going to want deeper shades, light shades, mid-tones, a variety of shimmers. There's duochromes in this palette. The packaging is absolutely stunning. That it's all Norse mythology based, and it is just an incredible collab. I really, really like the previous collab that Angelica did with Kaleidos, but that hasn't been in this previous year, so I'm not including it in this. I'm only including palettes I've picked up in this year, and I'm so glad I have this palette. I was even tempted to buy a backup, but I didn't. I stopped myself. I know, I stopped myself, but the colour story, the quality, Odens Eye, Angelica, this whole thing, amazing. And then the other palette that I couldn't not include is the Gourmande Girls Cosmetics palette that she collabed with Doodles by the Bunny to create Spooked for Halloween, and this sold out. I don't know if it sold out twice now, I can't remember, but I was kind of gifted this in PR. All the other palettes I have bought myself. This palette and colour story is just perfect for Halloween and fall, because if you half it this way, it's perfect for Halloweeny colours, and if you half it sort of that way, it's a really nice fall palette. But I would use this all year around. I love these kind of colours, I love these kinds of tones. We have a nice white matte, we have a really nice pigmented black. I love the fact that we've got some neutrals and some colours. The shimmers in here are spectacular. I can't say enough good things about this palette. I love this palette so, so much. Again, another US indie brand, absolutely smashing it. One of my favourites, and this palette had to be included because what a collab this is. I am so glad this is in my collection. It is probably my favourite Gourmande Girls palette. Okay, worst collaboration. Not the nicest of questions, but I was just trying to base it on things that I had bought myself. So I do have opinions about certain collaborations, and that's probably why I didn't pick them up and they're not in my collection, but I'm not going to be including those. I'm just going to be including things in my collection. And looking back through my collection, I really don't know if this was a great collab, to be honest. And it's the Makeup Revolution and Lion King collaboration, and it kind of looks quite childlike. Now, I know Lion King is a kids' film. I'm aware of this. But I don't know. I feel like a lot of people buy this kind of thing because of nostalgia, and I absolutely loved The Lion King growing up, and obviously they're aiming at people that enjoy The Lion King now as children and people that have grown up and have the nostalgia vibe to it. I don't know. I'm not 100% sold on the packaging. It is a little bit gimmicky. Okay, yeah, this one doesn't really have any depth. This green is a beautiful green, but it's not deep enough for me. Makeup Revolution have hit or miss formulas, and usually it's not my favourite formula in the world. I did pick these up because they are Lion King, and I do usually like Makeup Revolution's collabs a little bit more quality-wise than just the normal Makeup Revolution without a collab. They seem to put a slightly different formula in it, I'm not sure. But yeah, I don't reach for this palette. This never ever makes it out of the drawer that it's in. Same with this one. I don't think it's an awful colour story. It is kind of true to the film. I just think the quality isn't the best. I don't know. Was this kind of one of the Makeup Revolution quick cash grab kind of ones? Because I feel like Makeup Revolution absolutely smashed it with the Coraline collection. That was absolutely fantastic. The quality of the shadows were better than these shadows. Not the best in the world, so they didn't make it into the best collab question. But I just feel like so much more effort was put into the Coraline collection and the Shrek collection, and not so much with the Lion King collection, which makes me a little bit sad. But Yeah, it's probably one of the worst collaborations that I've picked up in my collection this past year. Okay, now we have best seasonal release, and because I've already used this palette in another answer, I am going to pick a different one, and this would have been included regardless because I absolutely love this palette and I'm so glad I got my hands on it. This is the Batty Bean and Shroud Hallobean palette. It is absolutely beautiful in every way. I do think two of my shades though are in the wrong way around. I don't know if it's Losers Club and Woodsboro. I don't know if they should, or is it Afterlife? I can't remember, but I know that my palette isn't actually the right way. It arrived to me like that. I'm not quite sure why. A few of my friends have the same thing, but this palette is such stunning quality. Every palette I have tried from Shroud has been amazing quality. I really, really like the tones that Batty Bean has included in this. I think she is an amazing YouTuber for a start, but the way that she's put this palette together and the colour story of it and the special shimmers that are in this, you want me to swatch them, don't you? Okay. They are absolutely stunning, buttery, creamy, delicious. 10 out of 10. Formula wise, absolutely amazing. Love the colour story, love the theming. Came out for Halloween. Obsessed. Okay, the palette that is still on my mind. Unearthly Cosmetics Vitality. I will pop a picture here for you of what this gorgeous palette looks like. It is kind of a rainbow palette, kind of. It is beautiful though. The tones that are picked, like the fact that you've got pastels, mid-tones, deep shades, a bit of a weird combination, and then all of the shimmers are duochromes. I'm sad that I didn't pick this up at launch. I have looked at it since, but Unearthly do have very, very high shipping, and although the palette is on the more affordable side for the actual quality of the shadows, I just, paired with the shipping, that's what puts me off, and I really had to decide if I wanted it in my collection because is it too similar to other things I've got, but it is the one that keeps popping to mind, and every time I see someone use it or talk about it again, I'm like, oh, I really wish I got that palette. Let me know, do you have Vitality and do I need it? What are you hoping to see next year? What am I hoping to see? I like to see more curated colour stories that are a bit funky, a little bit different, something a little bit unique, which I know is difficult in such a saturated market and nearly everything has already been done, but I feel like a little bit more innovativeness. Is that a word? Innovativeness? For example, if you're going to be doing a rainbow palette and you want to include a lot of colours, does it have to be just your bog standard rainbow palette? Can it be a little bit different, a little bit, something a little bit obscure about it? Even if it's the packaging makes a massive difference to me when it comes to eyeshadow palettes. That takes it to the next level. If the packaging is out there as well as the good quality eyeshadows, the theming, the colour story, like, packaging is on par for me with the colour story. Like, it needs to be good to be really grabbing me to want to buy it. Let me give you an example. My example is the Game Beauty Adventure palette. I've not long picked this up and I've been dying to try Game Beauty for the longest time, but this packaging, like, it is gaming inspired and themed. It's magnetic and it opens like this. Okay, so this color story, if it, that was a bit rude. This colour story, if it had been in a normal bog standard packaging, I don't know if it would have screamed to me as much, but the colour story is pretty. It's in this packaging that makes a real big difference to me and for me wanting to buy it. It's the whole package. It's not just the actual eyeshadows themselves. And I feel like colour stories like the Serenity, yes, I'm going to be bringing it out again. This is so beautiful. If more brands spent more time thinking about the colour stories and actually how consumers are going to be using them rather than just sticking a few browns in because that's what most people will probably want. No, spend time really looking into what other brands are doing so you can do things slightly differently. I really like what Cosmic Brushes did with this. You can tell that there's been a lot of effort and thought put into this colour story and I'd just like to see a little bit more of that. What don't you want to see more of next year? Pressed glitters. Do not give me pressed glitters. Please, please. I don't want pressed glitters. If brands want to bring out pressed glitters, please put them in a separate little single for people to buy that love pressed glitters. Please don't include them in palettes because the majority of people that I know and I watch on YouTube really dislike pressed glitters. And I don't want to see just a regurgitation of things that have already been done. Oh, here's another brown palette. Here's another brown palette. Here's another brown palette. Here's another rainbow palette. Here's another rainbow palette. Here's another rainbow palette. Like, just diversity, variety, and smaller palettes, not just gigantic, huge palettes that look like they've been thrown up in with colour and rainbows. Like, thought, time, effort into colour stories, I suppose, is what I'm asking for. So it kind of relates back to the first question. Yeah. Also, I don't want to see brands more or less duping themselves with things that they have brought out before. For example, I'm going to refer to Too Faced right now. Every holiday they release some sort of palette, like the, what are they all called? I don't even, pumpkin, spice, cinnamon, something. They are all regurgitations of each other. And I know they're quite popular. They do include a lot of browns. It appeals to a lot of consumers out there. But could we have a little bit more variety? What are your personal goals to improve on next year? Okay, I feel like I've started to do this and implement this over the past few months, but I've been a lot more selective as to what I'm buying and bringing into my collection. And it's not to do with how much money I'm spending. It's not really to do with what I need to review. I only ever buy what I like in makeup. I don't buy things just to review. Like, so many people have commented or asked me, oh, are you getting this palette? Are you getting this collection to review? And I'm like, well, no, I'm not, because I don't actually like it. So I'm not just going to be buying it for the video to review. It's just not the way I'd like to do my YouTube and work things, because why would I want to pick something up that I know I'm not really going to like to do a video on it? That's just going to be a negative video. That's not what I'm about. So I feel like I was selective anyway in only picking the palettes that I really wanted for myself to keep in my collection. But now I feel like I need to scale that down even more, because my palette collection has grown extensively and I need to do a palette collection video and a slight declutter within that. And I'm not the normal type of person that would want to do a declutter. I like to hoard makeup. It is my favourite thing to collect, especially eyeshadow palettes, but it's got to the point now where I have too many. So if I'm bringing too many things into my collection all of the time, it's just getting a little bit too much. So I feel like I need to scale it down even more, and it will help money-wise as well, to just focus on the things that really, really speak to me, that's different in my collection, that adds something, or that I really, really can't live without. So I feel like that's something that I definitely want to incorporate. And as well, I suppose, just being on YouTube, like, I don't, it's so weird thinking of myself as a YouTuber, but I suppose technically that's what I am. I'm on YouTube and you're watching me right now. But I feel like I would like to be a little bit more regular with my uploads and pick specific days to try and upload on, which has been a bit of a task this year because I've been quite busy. There's been one thing or another going off, and I know life sometimes gets in the way, but in general, I would like to kind of plan out, set days and times that my subscribers know that I'm going to upload on, and then it just, I don't know, it feels a little bit more structured. I'd like to plan a lot more. Sometimes I will sit down and think, right, what am I going to film today? And that is not really the best way to be going about doing a YouTube channel, in my opinion, but that is what I have been doing a lot of the time. And I think I need to actually sit down and spend some time planning the things out that I want to be doing on my channel and think of it more as a whole rather than just what is the next video. I really hope you enjoyed this video. I really enjoyed watching Annette's video and I can't wait to see more people do this tag. I think it's fantastic. Like I say, I will include Annette's video in the description box down below. Please check her out. She's an amazing YouTuber. I do love to watch her. And also I will include the questions down below as well in case you want to do this tag. Like I say, please do it. If you are on YouTube, please, please answer these questions. Or even if you're just on Instagram and you want to answer them in your Instagram stories, something like that. I do find the answers to these quite interesting. And if this is the sort of content that you enjoy, please do consider subscribing. I will have all my socials linked in the description box, as well as my YouTube membership and my Patreon group. And hopefully, guys, I will see you in my next video. Bye.